I forgot to turn it back down. Hello. Hello. Is that better, Lem? I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I had the music loud. Freaking sue me. What's up? It's on the floor over there.
Nice.
I'm quiet now. Am I still quiet? Listen, streaming's hard. You guys get it. We just got back from the suburbs.
We were in the suburbs.
It was fun. How about those Colts? Hell yeah, they haven't lost all year. Just yell into the mic? Yeah, I plan on doing that, actually. Oh, I just unplugged the Wi-Fi. That was stupid.
Oh, shit.
I mean, like, my computer's on Ethernet, but that could have been very dumb of me. Go Chiefs. The Chiefs lost this year.
I'm struggling, you guys. What?
No, not that one. You're from Wheaton? We were in Naperville/Aurora. Very, very close. I've eaten dinner in Wheaton. Would you say you're one with the burbies? I like the suburbs. I think it's a nice experience. Give it here. Let's see here.
Oh, it's that one, is it?
I don't know. But I'm just going to start twisting shit until something moves. That's this one right here, babe. All right. We went to Lou Malnati's, which is, if you guys aren't from Chicago, Jesus Christ.
What?
I'm so overexposed.
It's probably because of both the lightings right
now. Let me see if I can change the settings of the camera, actually. Oh, the camera's not even full screen. I haven't been on this setting, like full screen, in a while. We went to Lou Malnati's, which, if you guys don't know, is the best pizza in Chicago. The best, like, Chicago-style pizza. You know what I mean?
A chain. Oh, fuck. I messed up.
Hit the button by the blue.
Sorry. Just make it less loose. It's very loose.
It's the thing that I unscrewed, babe.
Nice. Okay, I'm gonna leave it alone.
Get Aurora back on frame here. It's already a shit show. All right. Yeah, perfect. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Okay. Now let me just set my thing back up here. So yeah, we just had Lou Malnati's, Aurora's first Lou Malnati's, which again...
It was very nice.
The thing is, Chicago-style pizza is very good if you have good Chicago-style pizza. So like Lou Malnati's is a lot more sauce than cheese, and it's very nice.
I think it's,
there's still a lot of cheese. Don't get me wrong.
The ratio is really good.
Yeah. Lou Malnati's is amazing. Okay. Okay.
How's my volume? Is it okay?
You and I are on the same volume. So
hell yeah.
If I'm quiet, you're quiet. If that makes sense.
Yeah.
But I did just increase our volume. How's everyone doing? Okay. We have to pop off. We have to send that we're live on Instagram and on Twitter. I'd be out here getting blessed with Aurora. My skin is clearing. Hell yeah.
Thank you, Len.
Have you ever had cops when I've been to Milwaukee? No, I've never had pizza when we went to Milwaukee. But man, I love a good pizza. Hello, Dylan. 11. You know you're the 11th Dylan that's been in here? Big fan of Zah. And look, I get it. I get it if you've tried Chicago-style pizza. And I know this is going to sound like... very, like... This is what everybody would say. But if you haven't had, like, the right Chicago-style pizza, you're getting a bad... It's getting a bad rap. Because good Chicago-style pizza is fucking awesome. And it's not, like, the lasagna soup that everybody describes it as. Oh, Cops is ice cream. We're also big ice cream fans.
I like ice cream.
Josh, I look like the kind of person who would beat some ass at a DIY hardcore show. That's a DIY hardcore show.
It's a pretty cool, small,
like, do it concert. Yourself. Like, hello, Lauren. Hello, hello, hello. Welcome, concert. Welcome. No.
I don't really know what genre they are, but are there any people in here that are a fan of the band Wand? Fucking awesome.
Oh, the scientist. Thank you for the Prime subscription. Does anybody know Wand?
I saw them at... Fuck, I forgot what it's called. I don't think it's running anymore, but it was this little bar in Chicago...
Perfect. Can't say I disagree. Folded pizza is god tier. I've had New York style pizza once, and it was in Denver. So Square pizza is very good. I do agree with that take.
I like square pizza too.
Circle pizza mid. It's too round. It's too round.
What do you mean? I think they mean square pizza like the way it's cut, right?
No, I think like Detroit style pizza where it comes out square.
Oh, nice. That's pretty cool.
Do you guys listen to a lot of indie to modern rock? I get that vibe. Aurora, would you want to field that question?
I do. I mean, lately I haven't really been listening to things that are that modern, just like going on like curated playlists to stuff I've already listened to. But yeah, like Wand is probably one of the most modern bands I listen to. They're so good. Heart Shape at Valentine's Day. I agree.
At Lou Malnati's, they had the they had the heart shaped pizza, and we did not get it. We went circle.
Yeah, Josh does listen to a lot of 2010s emo music.
I love.
And before 2010s as well. We were screaming. What were we screaming today?
I think mainly we were screaming.
If I could find you.
Yeah,
now.
Ocean Avenue by Yellow Card. And what's the one that has like the fucking
the accidental karaoke version?
No, that was Sugar We're Going Down. That was awesome.
I like Ranch, by the way. David B. King.
What was the song though? It's Dear Maria, Count Me In by All Time Low.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Ranch slaps with anything. Ranch on a quesadilla, not good. I'll tell you that right now.
Josh, do you know those bands, Knocked Loose and Every Time I Die?
I've heard of Knocked Loose. I think they've come up in our workout playlist a few times. Every Time I Die, I've never heard of.
I mean, if they're emo, I think you'd love them.
Probably.
I've never heard of them, to be honest.
Christian and Erica were at dinner, and he's pissed because he's going to miss part of the stream, which sucks for him.
We haven't started watching videos yet. It's fine.
It's like, not
he's
fine.
Around us at least once a week.
But he wants Paramore fan, huge Paramore fan. Paramore was the first album that I bought with my own money. Paramore's Riot. And then I bought 3 Days Grace 1X. And then I bought the self-titled 3 Days Grace.
3 Days Grace was my first concert, but I don't really count it. Oh, fuck, it wasn't 3 Days Grace. It was fucking Skillet.
That's so bad, babe.
Please don't kill me, friends. But it was at this Christian concert festival, and this one band played. They were really good. I don't remember what they were, but it was like more hardcore sounding than fucking Skillet, but yeah, it was my first one. I don't really count it because the crowd was huge. I wasn't really paying attention and shit. The first concert that I do count is I saw Winter Jam. It was fucking Winter Jam.
Oh my god, David. Shine Down and Breaking Benjamin.
No, they're dad, well, not really dad rock. They're like early 2000s bedazzled pants rock. You know what I mean? But the first concert I really count was when I saw Cage the Elephant in Foles. That was fucking awesome. I was 16.
Wow. That was when it was Selena Gomez in The Scene, right? That was her band. Spooky Meatloaf, I have a surprise for you. If you stay in here for the, what's going on? I have a surprise for you, we'll tell you that. Nickelback gets shit, but everybody sings along to Nickelback.
That's true. Especially that fucking, that one song where they're talking about, like, the dictionary.
Look at this photograph?
No.
Oh, because we all just don't want to be big rock stars singing. Nothing right at 15 bars.
Yeah. I don't like that song.
Modern dictionary of today's who's who. And we'll hang out in the coolest bars.
Why does, hey, Slashy, why does Weird Al make you sad that it was your first concert? What do you see?
I fell asleep at a Pitbull concert.
Yeah!
I feel like that's like, that would be like the opening line on like a weird episode of, I Almost Died, whatever that, what's that TV show called? Like, I Shouldn't Be Alive, and it's like flashes in.
Hi, Angel.
Fell asleep at a Pitbull concert.
Also, hi, Aunt Jennifer and Uncle Alan. They're in there, too. Your mom's right there.
Hello, Mom.
Right there.
I see her. You don't have to say hi. Mom, you're also going to be on this. I don't know if you remember, but there's a video that I posted on my old YouTube video that you are in.
Oh, fuck.
That's so funny that you fell asleep at a Pitbull concert.
Oh, my God. So my eyes aren't the best. I have bifocals. But I just laughed so hard orange juice squirted out of my ass. Not your nose.
Ass?
I read ass. I'm sorry.
Aurora's always reading ass, honest, to be fair. Aurora's never not reading ass.
It's fine, Angel. It's okay. I promise.
Went to a Ting concert to see Yeek. No one knew the opener. It was the most awkward experience ever. The Ting Tings? Is that what you're talking about?
Even though I read it wrong.
Never change it, Aurora.
Oh, right.
All right. Kiwi, thank you for the follow. Let us get into things. Let me just check something real quick, actually. Because I think I don't have alerts on right now, and I need to do that.
Funny. Judah's here, everyone, but you can't see him. He's walking away, shuffling away.
I need to get the alerts onto.
What's up, Delirium?
There we go. Yeah, I want
Tiger?
This.
I can't read.
On this one, I want this. Here. This should be working. Hopefully. If it's not, we'll figure it out. All right. So, now there's not that many videos here. But we've got some videos that I, for whatever reason, decided to post on to YouTube. Ranging from like
2010.
Starting in 2010. I don't know why I thought I was gonna be a Call of Duty content creator. But
Josh, you would have been on COD or Nah.
That's right. I am the original COD or Nah. And fortunately COD. Oh my goodness.
Holy shit.
Thank you for gifting 5 tier 1 subs, Donut. Thank you very much. You were 7 in 2010? Don't say that. Thank you, Donut. Shake It by Metro Station. Metro Station is the shit. Can we just say that?
Shake it.
Rowdy Ran, the Prime subscription. We're getting subs out the wazoo.
Thank you, friends.
Lem, you were 12. Listen, we don't have to talk about how old I am. I know that I'm old. I get that for me, 2010 was...
In 2010?
Yeah.
How old were you? 15?
I was 16.
I was 13 or 14. It depends on which month of the year.
All right. So if you guys weren't aware, 2010...
Ooh.
We're like 3 weeks apart. Hell yeah, Slushy. 2010... Black Ops 2. No, Black Ops 1, my favorite Call of Duty game. All right? And this is what we were working with. I was a big fan of a game mode called Sticks and Stones. where instead of using guns, you used ballistic knives, which only had 2 shots, and a tomahawk. And if you hit somebody with a tomahawk, it wiped all of their points out. And now this is, if you were paying attention earlier, when I was talking about Selena Gomez.
I don't know. Everybody tells me that it's so hard to make it. It's so hard to break it. And there's no way to fake it.
Yeah.
Everybody tells me that it's wrong.
Notice the name? XPWN3D. Pwned.
Oh, Jesus.
That was my PlayStation name, Pwned.
Christ.
My call sign, of course, being a unicorn with my football number on it. And the hearts.
Football.
Epic gamer moment with Selena Gomez in the scene playing in the background. So, you could call me a pro gamer. I was out here hitting 360 no-scopes. With tomahawks.
Wow. Nice.
Does that make me more hot to you?
I don't know what it means to me because I've never played Call of Duty before.
It's cool.
Okay.
Just trust me when I say that it's really cool. I think the only reason why I chose that song is because back in YouTube Editor, they had a list of like songs that you could put on there for free. And that was the only one that I knew.
Okay.
All right.
That's a free song for Josh.
Now, more Call of Duty gameplay. Of course. Let's just see what happens. Let's just see what I thought was cool. No music, unfortunately.
Are you talking?
Humiliation. That's it.
Okay.
Of course, from their point of view.
It's fine. Playing a game. Oh. Okay. Congratulations. You've killed them.
That was it.
He's killed them.
39 views. I feel like that's not bad. One like. It's my like, but one like. That's pretty good. All right.
We're crying out loud. Nice.
Now, this. No, I was lagging balls. So if it looks weird, it's because I was lagging balls.
Okay. Interesting song choice.
Hey there, Delilah. What's it like in New York City? I'm 1,000 miles away, but girl, tonight you look so pretty.
Dead, yes,
you
do. Gone.
I don't know that. I don't know why I chose plain white tees.
I will never know.
I thought, here's one no scope. I thought one no scope was going to blow me up on the scene.
You got it.
And if the content wasn't thrilling enough, let's slap on Hey There, Delilah.
Yeah.
L? Okay. L? Are you kidding me? Did you see that no-scope? Do I need to replay it?
No.
Look at this no-scope. You calling this an L? That's not an L. That's a W. That's an absolute W. All right. L? No. Dabba Daddy, you are teetering on the edge of a permanent ban. All right. Last Call of Duty. Last Call of Duty, I think. I could be wrong. Nope, there's one more after this. But this isn't even me.
Christ.
This is my friend who said, hey, you're getting views on YouTube. Upload my montage onto your YouTube channel.
Which friend was this? What letter?
J. Not currently friends anymore, really. I don't know. This isn't even me. It's like I don't even care about it. There's no funny music.
Just hanging.
It's
out
just
and call it
dudes being guys, shooting dudes.
Dudes playing Call of Duty.
Having fun. you know, as we do. There's actually one really cool kill on this, and it's right at the end.
I really don't want
to. Double headshot? Double headshot?
Sure.
That's pretty good. And I created this video at youtube.com/edit. 80 views. You know how hard it is to get 80 views?
No.
Neither do I. Next song will be like Call Me Maybe. No, these are pre-Call Me Maybe, but I do love Call Me Maybe. My bio on Twitter, I believe, is still...
My name is Josh, but you can call me Maybe.
Is that what it is? Some people call me Josh, shit. But you can call me Maybe. Dog shit?
No, just shit.
It used to be a feminist who likes to pay for stuff, which is a Bo Burnham lyric. All right. Now, people who know I love Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time.
Yes, he does. I do know Josh.
And this guy, Milo, I think his name is Milo, hangs out in the starting village. And that's all he does. And he's trying to move these rocks.
You know, the game says that this guy's supposed to be moving rocks in front of this dude's house. I think he's just really horny. Yeah. Kind of looks like Cameron. Just humping everything he sees.
Now, I understand why this one had 8 views.
It's so blurry.
It's taken from my phone, which was probably a flip phone. It was probably a flip phone. And then on a CRTV.
Video from my phone. Yeah.
It's just called Video from My Phone. And you know what? Video uploaded from my mobile phone.
No way.
There's value in being honest.
I guess, Josh.
You don't want to lie.
Sure.
That was from 2011. February 26th, almost to the year. Or to the day.
Almost 11 years ago.
Yes, Delirium. I only uploaded it because I was able to. All right. This is last Call of Duty clip. And this one is probably the most impressive one.
Okay.
Because this is for the win. This is for the win. I saw the kill, lined it up. I mean, come on.
Sure.
People in chat know. Like, that's pretty good. Like, come on. That's pretty fucking good.
The fucking replay.
Yeah, you gotta see it from all the different angles.
It's so funny.
If it was only from my angle, then you might not know that it was real.
All right.
And that netted me 33 freaking views right there.
Congratulations.
Okay. Now listen.
You've done it, Josh. He done it.
Somebody asked if you're going to hear a parody from me.
Oh, no.
And this is my first parody.
Oh, no.
So I was a big Justin Bieber fan.
Were you?
Yeah.
Seriously?
Mm-hmm.
You're not kidding?
No.
So is that why you had your hair like that, or is that because?
No, it's because I hated getting my hair cut.
Not because it was the style at the time?
So, no, correct.
An onion on your belt? Because it was the style at the time? Any Simpson fans out there?
So, I thought we had a class project. It was for English class.
All right.
It was for English, my senior year, English class. Senior year? No, junior year, English class of high school. You weren't expecting to be right. You were so right. I have 3 parodies tonight that you will be hearing. yes, Rora. Thank you, Jennifer. Okay. So we had a school project, and the project was to write a protest song circa Vietnam War. So some examples they played were you know, like Fortunate One by CCR, like stuff like that. You know that song.
Sure.
It ain't me. I ain't no fortunate son. Yeah.
Okay.
Now, me being a contrarian at the time was like, I don't want to write a protest song. Because she also showed us a song called The Ballad of the Green Beret.
Okay.
And The Ballad of the Green Beret is a pro-military song for the Vietnam War. And I thought it would be funny if instead of making a, like, protest song, I thought it would be fucking funny to make, like, a look how cool my Call of Duty team is parody.
Huh?
And so this is called Duty to the tune of Baby,
oh.
Justin Bieber. And now I could have just written it. The assignment was to write the lyrics. But for 10 extra credit points, you could perform it.
But you decided to do it in a video instead of in front of the class?
You had to record it and then upload it. Thank you for the follow. It was like 10%. So, I mean, it's a pretty good extra credit. And this is what I walked into class and played.
Are you on Jody?
Listen, none of us were singers. But goddamn, could I write lyrics?
You can sing better than that, Josh.
The main voice you're hearing.
What the fuck?
The main voice you're hearing is not me. Let me be clear.
Which one of those men or teenagers?
So this is obviously me.
You're so cute.
You can see the Bieber cut, Abercrombie and Fitch, Hollister. I was trying hard. This is the guy who had the no scope montage. This is friend of the show, Jake. Jake's been on our show twice on the Halloween episodes. And then Connor, Mike, and Ryan. The people who are on this song that are in this picture are just me and Mike. And then my friend Perry, who you cannot hear. You'll at one point hear a woman's voice, and that is it. And the entire 3-minute song. And then somebody who's not in this picture, Albert, comes in for the rap.
Okay.
So we can have the lyrics up on screen here. That way you guys can sing along.
I
want to
see.
It's so the video is just a picture.
Just that picture?
Yep, it's just the picture.
Oh, dear.
We'll have the lyrics on screen. We'll have lyrics on screen. No Fs in chat. That way you guys can sing along at home if you guys think it's fun to sing along to. No Fs. Lem, please ban everybody who's sending F. All right. Guys, it's only 3 more minutes.
Oh, God.
Dude, are you there? I just got home. I'll be right there. Sit on my couch.
Listen, I rhymed there with there. I started off rhyming there with there, but it gets better.
Okay.
It gets better.
Plug in my mic. We'll be playing Call of Duty all night. Get in the lobby.
People start saying, these guys look good, an understatement.
Once the match starts, their whole team starts to cry. They get mad and say we have no life, but we'll be playing duty, 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 on. Playing duty, 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 on. Playing duty, 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 on. I'll never go offline, line.
The sad part is I know all these lyrics still. This part I slap. And our clan will always be together. And we'll be playing you. And you'll be losing too.
We'll win every game, you won't forget the name. Got a 9 kill streak, got my Huey, and I'll be raining death for a minute so on your whole team. And when we nuke town, your whole team will leave.
Now, what if I told you this wasn't our first take? This was our third take,
oh,
I believe.
Oh, God. No.
And the best we could do on this part, is this.
When we nuke town, their whole team will leave after we release our hounds playing duty.
So after the second chorus, of course, the rap plays, normally by Ludacris. But this is Albert or Berta. After the chorus plays to us.
And I'll never go offline, Berta. In the first prestige, I got my first gun. Thought it was the best, and I leveled up, and I kept playing till I got every single one. I got to a Python, and I got my AUG.
Ran out of new tubes, 360 tomahawk.
Throw up some randoms. Three can't beat, cause it landed on your feet, and right when you think I'm done, my team station won't stop till the night ends. We'll go out guns ablazing. Final kill cam so amazing. Our win streak will never break, and we'll just keep on playing. Duty.
Imagine sitting in class and watching this. Imagine sitting in class and playing this for people.
10 points!
Another fun fact, Albert wasn't in our class. But he was failing a different English class with the same teacher. And therefore, he got extra credit points for being on this song with us.
Wow!
Which helped him have a better grade.
You saved your friend, Josh. You saved him.
So all of you guys making fun of me for this are actually mean. Because I actually helped somebody with this song. This song has brought more positive to the world than you ever have.
Sure.
Okay, so the song, the slushy, the assignment was to write a parody song about something that you would want to protest. So the example that the teacher gave was the song "Like a G6" by Far East Movement, I believe. Mm-hmm. And her protest was about people walking slowly, and so that song normally goes, "Pouring bottles with the ice." Like a smoothie. Dun, 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 looking groovy, right? You know that song? Like a G6. That song? So she did it walking slowly through the hallway like a turtle. Wanna jump over you like a hurdle.
How is that a protest?
It was fucking junior year of high school, guys.
Okay.
So... again, I didn't want to do a protest song. I did mine a la the Ballad of the Green Berets, which was like, instead of doing a protest song, here's just a song about us being cool. Overachiever, you didn't have to give subs for that, but thank you so much. Thank you so much. Pissy Chrissy finally getting the sub. Very nice of him. You made an Oedipus Rex parody of the same song in high school. Lem, you have to send me those lyrics. Legally, you have to send me. Okay, do we want to go over my other song parodies now?
Yes.
Or should we go to other videos and then come back to the song parodies?
What does everyone think?
I have two.
Do they need to recover?
Post the link. I'll post this link. I'm not posting the links to the other ones. So I'll... You guys want to hear the other parodies? I've got two other parodies. Neither of them are recorded, so I'll have to perform them live.
Oh!
But neither of them are recorded. But they were songs that I wrote in... You know what? Let me...
The Pokemon.
Let me text it, and I'll bring it up on my computer. This, yeah, and guys, Aurora decided to date me.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a good point, Tater. Huh. I mean, ultimately, I don't super care, but that's a good point. I'll do that. Thank you. It's mainly I just don't want oops. Thank you for the 1,000 bits you walked by. Oh boy, which one is it? This one here, yeah.
Looks like it, yeah.
There you go. All right. A podcast and a musical genius. Save some for the rest of us. That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. All right. So, Christian says this. Don't be so good you get flagged for copyright. I tried not to. That's honestly why I perform poorly, and that's the only reason why. So, and Christian will attest to this. our first date, I played this song, and I said, if you don't like this, we ain't going to work out, baby. Christian will attest to this, and Aurora and I do it all the time. I love singing along to songs and making up lyrics. It's very fun to me.
I agree. It's very fun.
And so it started in high school because I wrote that song, and I was like, well, that was easy. I can write other parodies, right? And we'll see later. I'm going to go through my YouTube search history on this account. But I love parodies. So I wrote a parody to, let me pull up the lyrics here. But I wrote a parody to Moves Like Jagger, right? The song by Maroon 5 featuring Christina Aguilera, called, My Favorite Move is Swagger, which is a Pokemon move. So let me pull up those pictures real quick, because Aurora, you can attest to this. You saw them. I bought one of the first things I bought when I got a job. I was 17, young, an idiot. And I thought, I'm going to buy custom Nike shoes, which were $160. And they were just tennis shoes. $160. But you could customize them. I completely customized them. We should have had a bingo card.
For what?
All the cringe shit that I'm doing. Oh. I customized them, and on the tongues of the shoes, I put on one TM and on the other 87. It was more than a whole paycheck, bro. It was a lot of money for me at the time. In 2011, adjusted for inflation,
right on top.
$198. $198. That's not a small amount of money for a young man, you know, with his first job. And you know how I know it wasn't a small amount of money? Because it overdrafted my bank account. Because I thought they were gonna come out at a later date on the purchase.
Angel.
But they didn't, and my paycheck didn't go through. And so I had to borrow money from my mom to go have a positive balance in my bank account. I'm going to pull up the pictures on stream in 1 second. I'm trying to multitask. Boop, boop, boop. Share. Let's put them in the drive. That'll work. Okay. Let me get a different thing here. Oh boy. I just, Aurora, at any point you want to break up with me, I totally get it.
No.
Where did I just save him to? Where did I just shave him to? Which drive, Aurora?
I don't know.
Which drive? Let's just email them to myself. I'm such a keeper. I know.
And he is a keeper. I like him.
Cringe.
Some would even say.
Don't say it.
I love him.
Cringe. Cringe.
You didn't hear that from me.
All right, all right, all right. Let me download these images real quick. Josh, stop. You're creating your own destruction. That's fine. What is life but, you know, undoing your own achievements? Come for the montages, stay for the parodies. That's what I'm talking about. Mystical Mushroom gets it. Okay. Let me minimize this. Let me pull up this box here. And let me pull up this picture. Oh. And then I have to. What? They're that good that you're covering your mouth?
Yes.
Why can't I pull it open? This one here? Where's it at? Where's it at? No. Oops. Don't look at my email, guys. What did I have open? YouTube. That's chat. What happened? What did I fuck something up? I'll have to change that in a second.
Ethan Ray, you are the asshole.
Here is the shoes.
Hair back. Slick your hair back like a piece of shit.
Finally, I figured out how to get on my computer here. These are the shoes. And look, they're pretty good kicks. Those are pretty good kicks. I mean, come on. No. This is in the living room, babe.
Hey.
Aurora thought that this was me beating off in the background to the shoes.
Not to the shoes.
This is in the living room. I don't know.
Looks like a lotion bottle and a used tissue.
I didn't come on my shoes, babe. This is in the living room.
Sure.
No. This was, you could go onto the, it's called Nike ID. You could go onto the website and do it. And I wore these shoes out. I wore these so much because I really liked them. And, not all. So yeah, you can see on the thing here, TM87. That's swagger. Not a lot, Tater. So TM87 is a move in Pokemon. It's Technical Machine 87. It's called Swagger. And at the time, of course, in 2011, 2012, swag was a thing. Everybody said swag. It wasn't just me. Everybody said it.
Unfortunately, he's right.
So
slotted sunglasses things.
Yeah, I never had those, but I really wanted them.
You can get them anywhere.
Yeah, I never got them though. Thank you for the follow. I don't know what about this stream made you want to follow, but thank you. Appreciate it. All right, let's get this back. All right. You had the word swag in your old username? Hell yeah, Lem. This is the shit. See, I think we should all be okay with, you know, saying this stuff. You know what I mean? Like, people should be more okay with, like, being embarrassed by their own self. Batman got swag, baby. That's what I'm talking about. Now.
Oh, actually, I have a picture. No, they're not slotted glasses, but I have a picture of me from, like, 2012 wearing similar ones. Hold on.
So I was a big fan of writing parodies, as I said. I got these shoes, and I was like, I can write more parodies.
you got these shoes. You're like, I can write more parodies.
And so a big song at the time was Moves Like Jagger. If you guys don't know, it sounds like this. This is the karaoke version.
Do you want me to sing along with you, Josh?
Yeah, because this is a very hard song to sing. And I'm actually a pretty good singer, but not on this song.
I don't remember how the beginning goes.
So we all know this song, yeah.
Oh, okay, okay.
So.
You missed the cue.
So if you see here, Aurora, the first words are just shoot for the stars.
Win the battle stars.
Yeah. Okay. As we lack eyes, yeah. Maybe we put this over here so they can see. It won't get DMCA'd is the thing, because it's going to be such a bad rendition of it that it won't even be recognizable as moves like Jagger. All right, you ready, Aurora?
Am I the only one doing it? Are you singing it with me?
I'll try to sing it with you.
Oh, God.
I don't remember this song at all. When the battle starts, we lock eyes, I feel in my heart. You don't think right, I'll blow you away. I'll make you all say, man, that shit was great. You wanted a show, well, you got one. Everyone knows, I've never lost one. That's big, I don't give a shit. You won't get a hit. And I don't miss out your Pokeball, and I'll show you. No matter who you choose, I'll clone you with my move. It's Swagger, my favorite move. It's Swagger, and all I
fuck you.
I can't hit that note.
Give that to me.
I don't need.
I'm embarrassed. I'm embarrassed. I can't do it.
Why are you embarrassed? I wrote it. You're a good singer.
I wasn't trying, Josh.
Unpause the song, Josh. Wait, keep going. That was fire.
No, it wasn't. Quit lying to me.
Are you guys hyping me up? The lyrics were slapping. Okay, okay.
You are a very good lyricist, Josh. Get dunked, Winter Blue. I wasn't trying.
Okay, okay. I was vibing. All right, all right, all right. All right, all right, all right. I'm sorry. Winter Blue.
I didn't mean it.
All right. We'll start in the next verse here. Right here. My favorite move is Swagger, and all I use is Swagger.
Oh.
When you feel it scar, nothing feels right. I don't know this part. But
it's
when you're
the...
Shush. No, it isn't. Oh, it's here. Hang on, we lost spot.
Yeah. I can't. It's hard to read.
Nothing feels right. Don't care who you are. You'll be broken and scarred. What is nothing is right? Oh, you'll lose sight. Nothing is right.
Where?
Okay. So it just ended. So. What the hell?
Huh?
Take it from the top. We're not restarting.
No. Yeah, that's the top.
Maybe it's hard. Okay, 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 okay.
Yeah, verse 2.
Ready? Maybe it's hard. Okay, okay. Ready? Swagger, and all I use is Swagger.
Oops.
When you feel like you're broken and scarred, nothing feels right. But when you're with me, I'll make you believe that I don't. Where is this at? Am I missing a screenshot?
I don't know. There are only two.
Am I missing a screenshot? Verse 2.
Don't care who you are. Is this a different song?
These are the actual lyrics.
Oh.
And I hadn't written them yet.
Oh, crust and a half, Josh.
Listen, this song sucks.
Yeah.
We're done with this song.
Sorry, friends.
The better song that I don't have the lyrics written down to, but I do know by heart.
Ooh.
Is even more. I'm sorry. That one I just saw. I saw screenshots of it and I was like, I barely remembered that. However, do you guys know a little man of the name Macklemore?
Speaking of Macklemore,
I'm out here holding out signs. Do you want to show that?
Ugh, sure.
Here's a nice picture of Aurora. This is around the same time I was doing this.
Yeah.
You were looking like this. Let me go.
I'm trying to see.
This is a real picture of Aurora.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's me. Oh, God. Loch Ness, you have no idea how many times I said that, how many times my friends said that, people I didn't like who were fucking Cookie Monster pajama pants mm-hmm. and Osiris's mm-hmm. smelled like shit asking me for a hug at the bus stop.
Osiris shoes.
Where's my hug? Fuck you!
That's so fucking funny. Okay. Okay, so we don't need this anymore because unfortunately I wanted to get home and write the lyrics for you guys so that way you guys could have them. Unfortunately, we spent a little bit longer in the suburbs than
we were eating beets.
Yeah, we spent a little bit longer in the suburbs than I was expecting.
I was just fucking talking to Josh about the iHeart boobies bracelet.
We were just talking about the iHeart boobies bracelet.
Did anyone else's peers wear fucking Hooters shirts like at 12 just because?
Silly band?
Yeah, silly. They're right. Oh.
No, I put them away.
I found some.
Aurora
dinosaurs.
Bought these for me for Christmas.
Yeah, I found them at Goodwill for 89 cents. Had to get Josh some stocking stuffer nostalgia.
Girls asked for hugs?
Really?
No, ours were like 48-year-old men.
I don't think anyone actually went by the sexual code that the jelly bracelets apparently went by. I think that was like...
Was that like the Livestrong bracelets? Like, is that what they mean by jelly bracelets?
They were just like this. Oopsie. Like a hair tie shape, but like a color.
Yeah, slap bracelets. They also got banned at our school. All right. So...
Hell yeah.
I could try to type up the lyrics real quick. Or if you want to keep telling stories, I can try to type up the lyrics real quick. You have any stories?
Hold on, I can't read.
Oh, I thought you were looking at what I was typing. Sorry.
No. One of my friends' mom knew it, and I was mortified. Thank you. That's a lot better. Mortified that she thought I was some experienced hussy. In her words, Jesus Christ. I don't know. I feel like nobody went by the actual code that those supposedly went by. Like, I feel like moms just talked about that shit because we're, like, parents / guardians in general, like, spreading rumors about weird things high schoolers do. They think euphoria is real.
Euphoria is real.
Oops. I mean, in real life.
Content warning on this. I do call Misty a bitch derogatorily.
Sucks, dude.
And I can't rewrite it because that would be...
You could just say, like...
I'll see if I can rewrite it.
Just be like, B word. You know? It's easy. I actually, so when I was in eighth grade, I had pink streaks in my bangs, just a couple pink streaks, and I went to this really tiny farm school. Made me very mad. Like, people made fun of me because I wasn't wearing, like, a camouflage Under Armour hoodie all the time. Like, that's what every popular person wore, and I had, like, purple skinny jeans and a pink Cure shirt. I actually got, like, the office called my parents, And they're like, she needs to dye her hair back to brown immediately. Because I had 3 pink streaks in the hair in fucking 2010? Like, what the fuck, dude? That's so rude. Like, I don't know. They sucked. They didn't like me because I was different. Josh is fucking jammed.
I'm trying to. I need to sing the song in my head to remember the lyrics.
Okay. I mean, maybe. I don't know. Did you live in central/northern Illinois? Buddy. Okay, I'll show you guys what it looked like. But yeah, people were very upset with me. Get ready for me not wearing my glasses, even though I've never worn contacts because I thought glasses looked bad because people made fun of me. But anyway, can you hold this up?
Yeah. Where's it at here?
That it's hard lights. To see. You can't see.
Is that slightly better?
No.
There. Oh, I had it for a second.
I'm very white. But anyway, I think my shirt says big things come in small packages, too. Yeah, I did.
I can't remember the lyrics. I can't believe I can't remember the lyrics. I think I need to have the song on.
You have so many.
I'm going to play...
You put so many.
I'm gonna play the song so I can hear it, but I'm not gonna perform it yet.
You're right.
How's the audio? Is that video too loud? Where's that?
Is the soundtrack to Thrift Shop too loud?
Rest yeah, sorry.
Phone users. Oops.
I still had it. I had it loud from the last one. Sorry. 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 Jesus. Is this too loud?
This is awesome. You're watching Josh remember lyrics in real time. I'm trying to think of other stories I have from that time period. Does anyone have weird stories from, like, 2010, 2012 era? Nuzzles. Jesus Christ. Jesus fucking Christ.
Nuzzles XD RAR. You guys are Nuzzles XD RARing in here? Thank you for the follow, slots for. Or saves for.
This one person that I used to be friends with, who I am not friends with anymore, I do not like very much. But they used to say, like, huggles all the time. My friends and I took vocational school for half the day in high school and spent most of the time playing our PSPs, battling our. This sounds like a good time. My good pal and I used to play.
I got it.
Nintendogs. And watch fucking Degrassi and Oren High School Host Club. I agree. It's a good podcast, Savs_4_.
This is going to change your thoughts on the podcast, I think.
As long as you don't say anything gross.
Just how bad it is. Is Josh part of the homosexual supporting cast?
Aww.
Did I miss context?
I think I did too.
Do I support homosexuals? Yes, if that's what you're asking. It's a reference. I don't know the rep. What's Orin?
It's Orin High School Host Club. I'm sorry, Winter Blue. I haven't seen that anime in about 10 years.
Crunchy thing to follow. Years.
I'm sorry. It's been too long. I tried to watch it again, and I can't. It's really hard to watch for me. I'm sorry. He's remembering. Neopets and Tamagotchi, go fucking get him. Oh my god. What was that thing called? It was like an orb. And they came in different colors. And they had this little magnet on the bottom. And when you press the magnet on the bottom, they open up like this. And they become like a cute robot dinosaur thing. And they were circles. Remember those? I forgot what they were called, but people brought them to school, and I loved them so much because they were basically Transformers, but, like, they transformed quickly and easily, and it was neat.
Chinese cabinet.
I forgot what they're called. Fucking, was it Bakugan? Oh my god, I'm gonna Google it. Battle Brawlers. Oh my god, it was! Look at them. Look at the little guys. Look at these guys. Hey, friends. Look at all those little guys. Bakugan.
Oh, I never had those.
Really?
I can't remember these fucking lyrics. The thing is, if I actually sing the song, I might remember them better.
You can sing it, Josh.
Josh gonna pop sometimes. Only got $20 in Josh's pocket. He is Josh. His name is Josh. His last name is Highsmith.
Thank you. Yeah, I remember that.
All right. I think I just gotta do it. I think I just have to do it. I'm gonna mess up. I'm gonna miss out words. It's not that I'm focusing on chat. It's hearing Aurora talk is just fucking with me. Like, I can't think of just it. And also, I haven't sang this in a long time. But if we go, I'll probably remember it better. Off the dome freestyle it's pretty much what I have to do here. All right. So let's get this all set up here. I've got some of the lyrics. I don't have all of the lyrics. I'll pop off then, homie. You guys are... I know you guys are just fucking with me, but thank you. All right. So this is a parody of Thrift Shop. I think it was just called Poke Shop. Okay. It should have been called Poke Mart, but it's just called Poke Shop. And it's a song detailing the events of a playthrough of Pokemon Red. And that's the premise of the song. Okay? Makes sense. Any Pokemoners in chat?
I've seen a couple.
You know, after Swagger, I had to come back with another Pokemon. Oh, Christian, what? Just in time, buddy.
What?
I'm pretty sure I performed this for Aurora at one point. I've performed this to every person I've ever dated. All right. I came in early. I'm gonna get that badge, gonna be all grunts in Team Rocket. I'm hunting, looking for that shiny. This is fucking awesome. Yo, walk up to the gym like, what up, I gotta beat Brock. But first, I gotta hit up the Pewter City Potion Shop. Take out the Gia dude, Squirtle so trusty. Brocktonic's like, damn, that's a mean-ass Poke team. Heading out to the east, next up that bitch will see. Not a good team, she got that star, you and that's on me. But wait, don't you ever think she will get the best of me. Thundershock her ass, cause I got that Pika P. And this is where it'd go, choo. Oh, shit. We already got the second gym. Ginny's copping it. All right. I have to restart because this is the only good part of the song.
Thank you, Christian.
Jenny's copping it, watching it, about to go and catch him, rocking him, head down to Viridian. Serge, I'll be shocking him, me and Gravler be rocking him. And that's the part where I forgot the lyrics. But listen, it was good at one point.
It was good right now. Didn't know that.
I'm trying to commit. My memory is failing me, which is very upsetting to me. I'm very upset that my memory is failing me.
It's all right.
I swear I perform this like yearly. I don't know why. Christian, when's the last time I sang this to you, Christian? It had to have been relatively recently.
Right. I thought you meant yearly to everyone you've dated each year.
No, like at some point I just like put it on and fucking play it.
Okay, because you've never done this for me.
I'm pretty sure, Aurora, I'm like 99% sure when we first started dating, we sat in our living room and you were playing videos of your friends and like your brothers on YouTube. And then I showed you the videos that I made on YouTube. And then, including the Justin Bieber parody, and then I always do this. I always sing this. So like anybody new that I meet that I think is chill, I perform this song.
Okay, so this would have been like over a year ago.
Literally within the first month of us dating.
I don't remember.
I could be wrong. Cool enough. I'm not trying to like gaslight.
I'm not cool enough, you guys.
I could be misremembering. I'm pretty sure I showed you this. You know what? Next stream, I tried. We need to go bound back.
No,
we gotta circle on back to the Justin Bieber parody. I promise you, I will rewrite these lyrics and I will have them ready for the next stream.
It was good though.
I just don't remember it after this point. It's Jenny's copping it, watching it, about to go and catch him, Rocketman. Head down to Viridian, Lieutenant Surge, I'll be shocking him. Me and Graveler be rocking him. Going straight to the top in here. Collecting all 8 badges, there ain't no way I'll be stopping here. I'm a digging to the ground. No, for real. All my Pokemon know how to do that now. Erica's gym was a real quick finish. Arcanine's Ember, then I'm off to Fuchsia, bitch. Had a poison leader. I beat a poison leader. Then I went to Saffron, and there I beat Sabrina. Oh, no. There's only 2 more to go. Blaine ain't got nothing on my badge game. Hell no. Head back to... It's not Viridian. It's head back to... Whatever city, that's the last gym you know. Giovanni be like, man, he got that slow, bro. No, he got that Gyarados.
Yeah.
And then it's chorus. Okay, so that's what I meant, is I needed to have quiet. Erica and Sabrina.
Yeah. Spam those question marks.
Okay, I'll... You're special to me, so I have this song. Yes. But you know this about me, Aurora. We have written a song parody together.
Yeah.
We have a song parody in the basement.
Huh?
That you and I wrote for Vindicated that we tried to record, but we couldn't get it to record properly. It was called Vaccinated.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
I still have that downstairs.
Yeah, we're not doing that. I think there was like a note that I just couldn't hit.
It's a very low register song, and Aurora wasn't feeling it.
No, it's not. Oh, it's a different... I keep thinking it's like the Avril Lavigne song. It's not.
No. It's Vindicated, I am selfish, I am...
Oh, God, fuck. Okay, don't
yeah,
remind me.
It gets
me.
Literally giving me a flashback.
I will be upset.
All right, I promise, I'm sorry, I'm failing chat, I'm failing stream, and I feel like a fucking piece of shit. I promise I will get these lyrics down for the next time I stream.
He's not joining the 27 Club, shut up.
Slushy, no. These will be my legacy. What is a legacy?
No!
That's Hamilton.
Eliza.
Eliza. Am I ending stream? No. So I'm going through an old song parody that I wrote, and I can't remember the lyrics, and I'm very upset with myself. So it's I'll have it later. We're not even done with the content on my YouTube channel.
No, not even close.
Okay. I mean, we are close, but. So if you missed it, we did a Justin Bieber Call of Duty song. We're not going to do it again. It's in the VOD. I need to fix this again. Hang on. Oh, I'm on display capture left. That's why. Okay. We did that one. This is not interesting. I don't know why I wanted to upload this, but this was in the middle of a rainstorm.
Yeah, I'm not going to go over there.
And there's a huge rainstorm in this restaurant.
It's going to break in like 2 minutes.
It's a restaurant? I thought that was your school.
No, this is a restaurant.
Wait.
Winter Blue, I guarantee you that the Discord is making trouble. But you can see the water piling up here. And we were just like eating dinner.
Yeah, video from my phone.
We're back to flip phone video from my phone.
It's gonna break.
Honestly, I think this video is from my iPod Touch.
One thing Josh and I have in common is that we both used an iPod Touch as a phone.
And then this is an alternate angle. So maybe this one is from my iPod Touch since it's better video quality and I'm on my phone.
Oh, did you get that?
Dude, I didn't do it, I swear.
So that's me. So that was fun. All right, Mom, I don't know if you're still in here. But if we scroll on down to this description, I came home from football practice. And my dad had been watching Tosh.0. And Tosh.0 did a little bit on Two Girls, One Cup. And my dad, being ever curious, was like, I got to know what Two Girls, One Cup is. And so he pulls it up. And I come home and I'm like, Mom, you got to watch this. Now, this video isn't very good. Other than my mom being hilariously innocent. This is my dad hits the fucking shit. And what's funny about this is sometimes I'll be, what a dated sentence. My dad was watching Tosh.0. Very
Josh
true.
Tosh.0.
I will be sitting in my computer chair and notice I have that exact same fucking posture and I stop myself. I'm like, oh, I'm not my dad.
What the fuck is that?
You just, it's comfortable. Look how comfortable I am.
You look comfortable. He does not look comfortable.
All right.
Jesus Christ.
So if anybody doesn't know, Two Girls, One Cup is a video where it's two women. I think it's two women. Yeah, it's two girls, actually. But they're women. And they starts with them just like making out softcore/hardcore porn. It's just like making out third base stuff. No, second base stuff. And then they start shitting into each other's mouths. And then they puke the shit into each other's mouths.
Josh.
They're eating it like ice cream.
Don't talk about puke.
That's the video. So that's what my parents are watching right now.
Do it.
Just click the go button on your search engine.
Can you guys hear it okay?
That's pretty quiet. I'll turn it up. Here.
Watch it right now.
Oh my god.
I thought they got removed from the internet.
My brother.
No,
and I
didn't.
Watch it.
No, wait a minute.
I think my dad was having trouble looking.
Oh,
Jesus.
Do not.
No. Watch it, Mom.
Do not record.
Watch it.
He's going to make bait. What are you going to do with that?
Nothing.
That is a fish tank in the background.
I hate the water noises. It's awful.
I didn't. No. I'm not making my parents watch this. I came home and my dad was watching it. And I'm making my mom watch it. I'm not making my parents.
He's encouraging them to watch it.
I'm sorry about the water noise.
Oh. Okay. Oh, God. No, okay.
That's not even the worst part. Watch the whole thing.
Oh, God, I can't. Oh, that is just awful.
Mom, watch the whole thing. Listen, it's not even close to being done.
I wanted her to get the whole thing. You can't watch
it's
part
not.
Of
it.
God, I hope that's fake.
You can't
it's
watch
not.
Part
it's
of it.
It's gotta be fake.
Nope.
If you watch
fake.
Part
they start,
of it,
no.
continue to live
what's
in
what's
this
fake.
Life and
nope.
believe that that's fake.
Yeah, the
no.
very soft piano music.
Oh, God, I'm gonna puke. Oh, God. And then, oh. I really am gonna get sick here in a minute.
This video is very traumatizing. Now... my parents.
Oh my
they
god,
knew.
That's awful.
No, it's not done yet, mother. You need to watch the whole thing.
I'm so over it. I'm done. Oh god.
Mom, just watch the woman shit for fuck's sake.
What on earth would possess them to do such a thing?
They love each other and they want to express it thoroughly.
Oh god, that's just wrong.
I also hear they got paid money.
I'm so very, very, very mad. I don't care how much money. There ain't enough money in the world. Oh.
That's pretty much it. Sorry, Mom. Not only were you on YouTube, you're now on Twitch. My dad was watching Tosh.0, and Tosh.0... showed like parts of it, but like obviously heavily
censored,
and my dad being curious wanted to go watch it. Okay, now there's only two videos left. There's another Call of Duty montage that's not mine, but this is where we get into the good shit. I had another school project. Aurora has not seen these. I think she's seen most of everything I've shown her. I guess you hadn't seen the Call of Duty stuff, but we watched some of the stuff together before. I had another school project my senior years for speech class. We had to make a 20-something minute video. And I can't remember the rules or the stipulations of it. But in it, we had to have like commercial breaks, like 3 commercial breaks.
Wow, what the fuck?
And we had to shoot the... yeah, mom watching a reaction of her reacting. We had to have commercial breaks, but we had to shoot the commercials. So it was a speech class. It was supposed to be like video. You had to learn like kind of like videography and like all this stuff. So this was. I only have the commercials. I don't have the full video. It was on my brother's old YouTube channel, and then he actually started uploading like actual content, and so he got rid of it. Honestly, he might have just privated it. I should actually ask him if he has that link. Will or Vanessa, if you're in here, let me know if he has that link. Yeah, I'm a quintuple threat. Director, rapper, singer, podcast host, professional gamer.
Lyricist,
yeah. I got a lot of talents. So this is a hammer commercial. This is a commercial for a hammer. You know a hammer. Right?
Yeah, the tool.
Yes.
Right.
Oh, hey, I saw you looking at my hammer. Wanna try it out?
Okay.
Scare your friends with a hammerhead shark costume.
Oh!
Or a bottle opener.
It's not Josh, you guys.
It could be a food processor.
I wrote the jokes in this and I directed it. I'm not in this video.
Or even a juicer.
Ugh.
Yeah, the heart wipes. Diamond wipe.
And for fun with your friends, you can play catch.
Of course, playing monkey in the middle.
You can even use it to break an iPad.
Why'd I do that?
Oh, fuck. I forgot this was part of the cinematic universe, and we had to watch the other one before this one.
Oh,
We had to watch the other one before this one.
Let's watch the other one. Right,
we're going to pause the last 7 seconds so we can give you guys the lore dump, okay? So that was the run-up, and now we need to do the lore dump, okay?
There's Josh.
Now, I need to preface this. Again, obviously I'm in this. I wrote the script. The iPod joke was pretty funny. Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Why would I do that?
That's what I'm saying.
Classic.
This is Lord Cannon and her fan, and it's all of them, honestly. Now, I obviously very good at writing jokes. Coming up with names is hard. So I may have recycled the name.
Okay.
You should vote Ned Schneebly in the upcoming election. Ned Schneebly will bring back the Constitution and enforce all of its rights. Ned Schneebly promises to restore the Constitution to its old supreme power. And most important, Ned Schneebly is a heartfelt American.
That's why you should vote for me in the upcoming 2012 election. You can't even knock Ned Schneebly up on the political campaign.
Call now.
All right, I had it mixed up. But look, it's a callback. There's a hammer advertisement in the political campaign.
Okay. Nice.
And that's called a fucking callback. I thought that was on the other one. My bad.
One might wonder where you can buy such a thing. Go to your local hammer store and buy one today.
Hammer store.
Go to your local hammer store. Yeah, and now everyone's like, you know, I need a new hammer. This was 4 years pre-Pokemon Go to the polls. Hillary should have fucking called me up. I knew how to write a goddamn political campaign. Okay. So that's all the videos. That's all the videos on my YouTube channel. There's one more Black Ops clip. I don't even know what this is. But it's a game clip. There you go.
Congratulations.
It's not me. It's not me playing. However, this YouTube account was created pre-Google. Menards isn't okay. Yeah, you can save big money there. This YouTube account was pre-Google. So when Google bought YouTube, all of your old YouTube accounts, you didn't have to have a username, or you didn't have to have an email account associated to it. But when Google bought it, you had to tie that account to an email. So because of that, this account, once Google bought YouTube, I just created a different account. It's what I use on my main one for all my other stuff. This account has not been touched since like 2014, I think, is the last video. And so I have all of the watch history on my YouTube account. Okay. So I started to go through it for a second, and I thought some of these were pretty fucking funny. I haven't dug through all of them entirely, but I'm sure it's fine. I showed Aurora some of them because I thought they were funny. There's a lot of boobs. Okay, I'm gonna be honest.
Boobs.
There's some
because the
there's some
now.
There's some videos in here that I definitely only clicked on because it had boobs in it. All right, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, but this is the first video I've ever watched on my account. Does anybody know who Eric Surf 6 is?
No.
Eric Surf 6 was, I think he was an American living in Japan, if I remember correctly. He lived in some Eastern Asian country. And I think he was like an English teacher or something. And he made these YouTube videos of doing like little tricks and stuff. And I thought this shit was so cool. As you can see, I was a big Eric Surf 6 fan, being the first 7 videos that I watched on this account.
What's the cool coat hanger trick?
Let's watch the cool coat hanger trick.
You watching Eric Surf 6. Get some.
Hi there, this is a video response to System Jap's coat hanger trick.
Sorry. Okay, so the cool thing about Eric Surf 6 was he would do intros that were like his fans would send in. So his this is a fan of his that said, "Here's an Eric Surf 6 and or Eric Surf 6 intro."
You watching Eric Surf 6? Get some.
Hi. And his catchphrase. Did you hear what his catchphrase was?
Get some.
Get some. You goddamn right. It's get some.
Is that why you were watching him, Josh? You're trying to get some?
I was trying to get some, yeah.
There, this is a video response to System Jap's coat hanger trick. Bring in the talent. Who are you guys?
We're undercover.
You're undercover? Huh. All right. Well, here, we're going to take the coat hangers, and what you do is you put it over your head. Okay, these are wire coat hangers, so it's nice and firm on your head. And then you let go and relax your neck. What happens? Whoa! That's pretty cool. Your neck actually twists. It's really weird. You feel it working?
Huh?
Right. It's got to be tight, though. All right, let's try it the other way. See if it works the other way. Ready?
What? Could you wait for me?
Yep. Okay.
I'm ready.
Got it? Mm-hmm. Can I go? Really work?
All right. Here's what I'm thinking is happening. There's built-up kinetic energy inside the hanger. And so when it's tight on your head, the twists on that thing is rotating your neck. But you, on your own, are just stopping that from happening. But if you release your neck, the wire hanger puts that torsion on your neck. So they're relaxing their neck, and they're just doing this. I think that's what's happening. I thought this shit was riveting back in the day. And there's actually something that I learned on Eric Surf 6 that I still do as a party trick to this very day. And by say that, I mean I just remembered it. But can you... Let me go full screen here. Put your hands out like this. So you're crossed and you have your fingers. Come up. Put one finger on both sides of your nose. And then... And then release it so you don't take your fingers off of your nose and your hands are like this.
Okay.
Mystical Mushroom, why would you fucking ruin it for everybody in chat? Why the fuck would you ruin it for everybody in chat? So, the trick here is that if you tell people to do that, most people will thread their fingers with their right hand on top. And so, my right thumb is on top of my left thumb. And when you go to do it, you physically can't do that. But Aurora just happens to be one of the small percentage of humans that if you thread your left thumb on top and do it, then it works. And that's something that, like, Eric Surf 6 did. I don't know. I don't know why I like this guy so much.
Coin spinning contest results.
Hi there, and welcome to the results video for the coin spinning contest. There were a total of 154 entries that qualified for this contest. Here's your video.
He's a side talker. Anyway, all right. Now, then there's a nice period of my life. Eric Surf 6 wasn't doing it for me anymore. It's fine. And then we go into trick shot videos. And I don't remember any of these specifically, but my personal favorite trick shot video is a video. It's got Stevie Wonder playing. What's that song? What's that song? It's like, I can feel it all over.
Oh, fuck.
I can feel it all over now. Is that Stevie Wonder or is that Ray Charles?
It's Stevie Wonder. I forgot what it's called.
Sir Duke. That's what it is. So there's a, it's called Sir Duke.
Is it?
Yeah. There's a trick shot ping pong ball. And it's got Sir Duke playing. And I think about this video like every now and then. Whenever I hear Sir Duke, I think of this video.
Wouldn't it be on your history?
I don't think it is. When I was looking through, I didn't see it. But maybe we will see it. And then real quick, let's see here. Let me turn off this real quick. There's stuff from my personal information in there, so we're going to skip that real quick. Okay. Now, Bo Burnham starts. I don't think this is every video that I watched. Obviously, I watched YouTube videos that weren't on my search history. This is where I discovered Bo Burnham, was 2010. And man, was I a fan of Bo Burnham. Here's
yeah, hand vagina.
Here is one of my old videos, of course, the 360 jumping tomahawk kill. And I was a huge fan of College Humor. I can't tell you why or what started it, but I'm going to, maybe it's these two. Maybe it's the ones with the boobs and the hand vagina. It's a possibility. I'm just going to say it's a possibility. But I was a huge, I've always been a huge fan of College Humor.
Shall we look and see what those videos are like, Josh?
You want to see hand vagina or guy stuck in history class?
You guys, boobs or hand vagina? Choose. Quickly.
When can I do a poll? I'm going to try to start a poll.
Okay, we got boobs. Okay, booby. Send bobs. Okay, boobs, Josh.
I'm going to start a poll for a minute. History class? Boobs. Or hand V.
Hang V? You spelled it wrong. Christian says bobs. I remember that. I remember this one YouTube channel that, like, was dissecting weird objects, and they found, like, interesting trinkets inside of them, but I didn't understand that they had already planted those things inside the other objects, and I was like, oh, that's cool, and I wanted to, like, take apart the VHS tape or the VHS player at my house and look and see if there's anything cool inside. I didn't do that, though, because
thanks. Boobs is killing hand vagina. Let's just say that.
Yeah.
I don't remember old Greg. One of my first...
Yes, you do!
Huh?
Josh?
What?
Old Greg from The Mighty Boosh. It's Noel Fielding.
I never watched The Mighty Boosh.
It was probably playing in reruns on Adult Swim. Do you remember that guy?
No.
Huh?
Do not remember him. All right. We, 70% of you guys want boobs. So, we're doing boobs.
Guy stuck in history class.
Booba, please. Big Mommy Milkers. Okay.
Bubs.
For its loss of Florida, France ceded control.
How could I know that? I guess I kind of have a sense of how big my butthole feels, and right now it feels a little bigger than usual, so it'll probably be silent. Just as insurance, I'll cough. Oh, draw cubes.
Classic joke.
Couldn't have been me.
Draw cubes.
Draw cubes.
Who hasn't drawn a cube or two in class?
Yes.
Have you seen that window?
Oh.
Okay, not really an option at this point.
The last of four major colonial wars fought by the British, French, and their respective allies.
Unlike this video is what teachers think when they say girls can't wear tank tops.
Because just, they're looking at underage boob.
The narrator is talking, Sarah.
Here if you put yourself the guy behind the camera. The opening
it's a POV.
A bottle.
This is... This says season 1, episode 24.
It's not Josh's videos, cat.
No, these are not Josh's videos. History. This is my watch. This is my entire channel's watch history. This is a series in College Humor where they did POVs. So this is one of the series of POVs. Like a POV is the guy stuck in the history class.
Did you get a boner? What would happen? You'd get stuck. I guess why would you get a boner in the first place unless you like to fuck tiny replicas of seafaring vessels?
Oh, hey, oh, what's up, bro? No, I'm up. Oh, no, oh, man, just don't give in to the warmth. Oh, okay, I'm back.
No, it's not here. Funny cool, anymore at all.
Unicorn.
Yeah.
Let's just skip.
Okay.
Oh, my God. I am definitely still dreaming. Okay, what page are we on?
Mr. Barr, can you...
Not a good video.
Boobs.
But hey, you know what?
You did your best, you know.
Great, great thumbnail. Oh, I have to scroll back down. Hang on.
Why are you glitching so hard? Holy shit. What was that? Balloon Chop's fucking awesome.
Okay, all right. I think we're here now. Definitely getting close. All right.
There you go. Got those boobies.
Okay. Hand vagina, which was just a kid looking at his hands, of course, when you do like this. You know what I'm talking about? Do you know what I'm talking about? You ever do the hand vagina? Put your hand like this and then...
Oh.
And then look in there. Yeah.
No.
That was the hand vagina. Some Call of Duty clips, you know. I was trying to get notes. I was taking notes on like... What, like, look at this. 1.6 million views, that could have been me.
Could have been you, Josh.
That could have been me. Orgasmic Tomahawk Throw Black Ops, 13K views. That could have been me. Some magic, of course.
Bed Intruder Song?
Now, this starts my parody era. There's a YouTuber by the name of Dave Days. I don't actually know who Dave Days is. Mm-mm. Dave Days was a guy who created content based mainly on the fact that he had a cardboard cutout of Miley Cyrus. And he would sing songs about how he wanted to date the real Miley. But he all he had was this cardboard cutout of Miley Cyrus. And I loved this guy. I thought he was so fucking funny. Back in the day. I imagine he fucking sucks. I'm trying to find one of his parodies here. This song, do you guys know the song Lollipop by, is Lollipop by Lil Wayne? Gonna let you lick my lollipop. You don't know that song? Well, this is a cover of Lollipop.
My Lollipop cover.
I was never a Fred fan. I never watched Fred. Okay. Sarah, you missed a whole section of me singing earlier. Like, look how cool this guy seems. Thank you, Slushy. Thank you for complimenting my little Lane impression.
Had a swag like mine. She even wear her hair on her back like mine. I make her feel right.
I thought this dude was so fucking funny.
What the
f- so you can see, like, this is a cover of Miley Cyrus's Seven Things.
I probably shouldn't say this because my friends think that I'm weird. But every time I say I love you, and they remind me you can't hear. It's because you're cardboard. I'm always ignorant, but you feel so real to me. Why can't they see?
29 million views.
And you're still standing in the same way, just how I left you yesterday. Against the wall, you fall.
I feel like
the seven things I hate about you.
This isn't Fred. This is David.
You. You're fake, you break, you are not real. If only I had something to feel. You are 2D with no backside. You can't be quiet.
No, it's not Dear Maria. This is a Miley Cyrus song called Seven Things. It's actually a very good song. Anyway, that was my Dave Days era. He did a cover of the Bed Intruder song. Do you remember the Bed Intruder song? It was the guy who was on Hide Your Kids, Hide Your Wife. Yeah. And then Shmoyoyo did a exactly David King. Shmoyoyo did a mashup of it, of like the song. And apparently this video, I don't remember this at all. 2 million views of... I don't remember that video at all. But you can see this sprung me into parodies, mainly by Dave Days, but Venetian Princess, Lady Gaga telephone parody called Accident Prone, a little bit of Dave Days, John Lennon Imagine cover, Avril Lavigne Imagine cover. For some reason, Snorg Tees, I imagine Dave Days used them as a thing. I really liked Snorg Tees for some reason.
Call of Duty.
Here's my Call of Duty. Call of Duty Black Ops Uzi in the jungle.
Boobs.
Probably just because of boobs. Back to parody. Eye of the Tiger Survivor parody. Black Ops. Maple Story? Any Maple Storyers in chat?
Never seen that in my life.
Maple Story? Maple Story was a Korean RPG.
McDonald's, Sarah. Huh?
Soft serve from McDonald's or Burger King? Gotta go McDonald's. Some more thing. And then John LaJoie popped into my life. And boy, is John LaJoie funny. And you know how I know he's funny? I believe.
Anything called love.
So let me text my brother real quick. So John LaJoie, if you guys don't know, I'm sure you've heard the TikTok audio of it's a bad rap song. And it's like, women are stupid and I don't respect them. Just kidding. I just have sex with them. Show me your genitals. That's John LaJoie. He was also an actor. He was on a TV show called The League. But he made all of these, you know, dumb fucking songs, yada, yada, yada. He had a commercial, or a fake commercial. You can see here, he has a commercial for hands.
Are you tired of this happening? What about this? And how many times has this happened to you? Well, suffer no more, because we've created a product that is designed to eliminate these problems and improve your quality of life significantly. Introducing Hands. Hands were specifically designed to facilitate manual tasks and to eliminate problems associated with...
Vanessa, is Will there? Ask him if he has my old high school speech project on his YouTube channel. But
not
he did these
hands,
fake commercials, and one of them is breathing. He did a PSA commercial for breathing. And then I just straight up stole that video and wrote it into the speech project we did. And that was one of the commercials we ran. Anyway, back past John LaJoie. COD Ghost to the tune of Let It Go. That's way too recent of a parody. There's no way I listened to that. Now, Will, Vanessa, good thing you're here. I've been in one car accident. Okay? One car accident. I was in high school.
Huh?
I was 16 years old. 16 or 17. I was driving my brother's car. And I was going to work out. And I took some pre-workout. Okay? Josh, knock on the table. Oh, I'm not superstitious. Whatever. I was driving to go work out. And I had some pre-workout. And it was Jack 3D. And this was later banned because it legitimately had, like, cocaine in it. Like, it just straight up had, like, remnants of cocaine in it or some stupid shit. It got banned. I had just taken this. I was driving to work out, was driving aggressively, and ice rear-ended somebody. And I had to pay to, like, fix my brother's car.
Josh!
I don't know why I was watching videos on Jack 3D, but there's my Jack 3D videos. How to create YouTube videos with your mobile phone. And then I made videos from my phone.
God, that guy's hair is insanely bad.
Ian Hecox?
Yeah.
So I used to get comments that I looked like Ian Hecox all the time.
I don't see that.
Back when I had this hair. It was literally just the hair.
Oh.
I was a huge fan of Smosh. Whoever said earlier about Smosh doing the Pokemon video... I started back then too. Vault Winter Blue. I drink so much fucking Vault and Jolt Energy drinks. Then Jolt Energy made mints, which are just straight caffeine. And I took those two in high school. And then for some reason, just songs. Ludo, Love Me Dead, this song fucking slaps. I don't know this song. Hey Monday, couldn't tell you if these songs are good or not. A little bit of 30 Seconds to Mars. Selena Gomez's YouTube video, her first YouTube video.
My YouTube.
Chingo Bling, he had a song called Osama, Who's Got the Keys to My Hama, which is a parody of, what song do you sing? It's like, you say something about
it's
like...
It's a Missy Elliott song.
It's a parody of Missy Elliott. Some more Call of Duty. Smosh, My New Hot Girlfriend, of course, of course. Selena Gomez in the Scene, very, very good. Let me just get some, you know...
Football.
Football, baby.
Football.
Someone saying...
What?
That's kind of gay in a video, or in a football, I guess. Northern Illinois versus Iowa. Millionaire idiot. This guy is so stupid.
You're our first contestant so far this season from Oregon. It's nice to have you here.
I'm very proud of that fact.
Yeah, and I understand you're sort of in between. You and your wife took a year off from work. Travel and...
It was actually my wife's idea. Last year, she came up with the idea that we should both quit our jobs. We were both attorneys. And that's what we did. We quit our jobs and we traveled. We had some money that we saved and we just blew it all and went around the world.
Oh, so you have so many people probably envy that because that takes a lot of guts.
For a person like me who's a type A personality, yeah.
Yeah.
It really scares me.
And to know you did it, you're happy and probably broke, right?
Completely.
Well,
it's not that
bad. You know, but you've come to the right place because the $1 million could certainly come in handy.
That's the hope.
You know the rules. You know the lifelines. You ready to play?
Let's do it.
Okay, let's play.
Good old Meredith. I love Meredith. This is like the only show I remember watching.
Which of these phrases is a common way of saying, I can't take it anymore? That's the last stick. That's the last leaf. That's the last straw. I'm moving to Canada.
Hey, that's the last stick. Final answer.
Oh, buddy, no! Oh, God!
I mean, that's... Oh.
Idiot.
He said final answer. He can't go back.
Absolute idiot. I don't know why I thought this was very funny. C word on Wheel of Fortune?
The
no.
Canada. Oh, God.
Listen, guys, I told you.
Best sex ever.
We'll go past the butts because I don't want to get like flagged or anything. But look, I told you. It was 2010. Listen.
Mythbusters.
Carrie Byron.
Big ass.
Bends over.
Fuck yeah. Fuck yeah. Yeah, buddy.
Listen, R.I.P. Carrie Byron. I think she's dead. Is she dead?
No, Grant, I think.
Grant is dead. I thought Carrie died too.
Hold on. Oh, God.
Thank you for the follow, Yoda. You just came just in time. Hello, could you react to the video called The Wedding of the Guinea Pigs, please? After maybe we're done going through my search history. Will, thank you for the subscription with your Twitch Prime. Any other primers in chat? You can subscribe for free. Just link your Amazon
She's alive.
Prime account. She is alive. That's good. To your Twitch account. And then you can do it. All right.
Grant died in 2020.
That's right. That's 2020. Okay. Don Beebe bounces on his head. We played against Don Beebe's son in high school, and Don Beebe's son went into that sucks. Will Don Beebe went to the NFL, so we played against an NFL player. Hot girl accident. Dog humps drunk girl.
Ugh.
I don't know what this one is.
I don't like that. I don't like what.
But hey, you know what? Then we get into science.
Go back down a little bit. Pregnant robot train student.
It's science.
Oh, okay. Okay.
That was when I was doing pre-med stuff, probably.
Bye, Dylan. 11.
Goodbye, Dylan. Thank you for coming. Mermaid syndrome, which is where they're born with their feet fused.
Nice.
That's what I'm saying. Look, I'm not proud of it, but they're there. Teletubbies shake that ass, bitch. That's got to be a good video.
Sure.
How old was I? I was 15 on these.
Yeah.
Hey, here's the re-uploaded version of Smosh's Pokemon. So there you go. People getting hit in the nuts.
What?
This is it, baby.
Oh, you're
This is the ping pong. Yeah, this is the ping pong ball.
Is it too loud, you guys?
That was everybody working for the weekend. But yeah, there you go. Trick shots. My Call of Duty. Okay, now Aurora, I know I'm not gaslighting you. When we talk about this, I just showed you these videos like 2 weeks ago.
You showed me that one.
Yeah.
I don't like that one.
Carmen, huge, huge recording artist. She has actual songs on the radio, or at least she did. I was a huge fan of Carmen. I loved covers. Like, all I listened to was covers. And so here's Carmen doing Look At Me Now. Don't know why. And listen, I liked seeing girls doing covers, apparently. Yeah, my mom is fine. I do not remember watching Rooster Teeth. I do not have any core memories of Rooster Teeth.
Haha, Lion King in 5 seconds.
Movies in 5 seconds, Dark Knight in 5 seconds, all of these stories in 5 seconds. Here's the breathing commercial I was telling you about with John Lajoie. Band ads.
I used to watch those too.
I don't know why. Sexy band commercial. You know I had to watch that. Band underwater commercial. Fun. Too short. Smosh. I don't even know if there's anything even interesting after this point. Angel's reaction to Two Girls, One Cup, of course. Oh, boy.
Oh, Cobus. My God. The best optical illusion.
Well, Cobus is a drummer. I used to fucking love Cobus. I thought Cobus was the coolest fucking dude in the world. I think he's South African. Why would I look up anything about being too short? You just got to know. I'm going to scroll through. There is a video in here that is so fucking funny that it's in my search history. Wait, what?
Oh, no.
Did I accidentally scroll down?
I don't know what happened. I used to watch Salad Fingers.
The Prancer Size Lady? No, I know of the lady. Friends.
Salad Fingers, Happy Tree Friends.
All right. Then I get back into my fucking dubstep era, but it was only people dancing to dubstep. It started with this dude's video. I thought this shit was the coolest thing ever. I don't know why. Loved that. Loved that guy. Pokemon parodies, which is what, of course, inspired mine. There's a really funny string of... there's a really... Moves Like Jagger dubstep remix, of course. A little bit of Skrillex. There's a really funny string of videos I saw when I was going through this. Kingdom Hearts. Gotta love Kingdom Hearts.
Winter Blue. I think I remember seeing the... I don't know if it was really anime, but it was an animated music video to a Radiohead song. I think it was from In Rainbows. I forgot which one it was.
Lem, Nightcore. I don't know if Nightcore is going to come in this, but I used to, every single song that I liked, I would look up a Nightcore version of that same song. Little bit of Liam Kyle Sullivan with Let Me Borrow That Top, of course, okay. Also famous for Shoes. Pokemon dubstep remix. Dane Cook. Bo Burnham. Here starts my comedy phase. Woo! Epic rap battles of history.
Please don't watch those, Josh. They're so...
And then Watsky. I used to really like Watsky.
Peter says, whoa, whoa, whoa.
The official. 10 minutes. Did I ever listen to Daft Punk? Not really.
Daft Punk is good, Joshua.
I watched Jack Chop after, and it's like, I'm almost done with this. I used to love Epic Rap Battles of History. I used to watch so many of them. I thought they were so fucking cool. Campfire Song Song Dubstep Remix?
Oh, shit.
I mean, come on.
I call this one the Campfire Song Song.
Is the drop at C?
Let's gather around the campfire and sing our campfire song. Our C-A-M-P-F-I-R-E-S-L-N-G song. And if you don't think that we can sing it faster, then you're wrong. But it'll help if you just sing along.
Bum, bum, bum. It wasn't even good.
That's awful. Jesus.
Nah, wasn't that real?
No.
Herbert the dubstep pervert.
Peanut butter jelly time. Dubstep remix.
Saria's song, possibly the best remix. Legend of Zelda remixes. The Duck Song. Everybody loves the Duck Song.
I don't love.
Here's more Epic Rap Battles of History, of course. Explosive Farting. We're not
Josh!
Gonna watch
that. Okay, thank you.
Asdiff Movies, part 1, 2, 3. Okay, okay, okay. A little bit of Try Not Ridge. To Laugh. You laugh, you lose. Patrick saying,
"I have 10 minutes of fancy with."
There was a bit where I thought the 10 minutes videos were the funniest fucking things in the world, and I would just play them in the background when I was in public gatherings.
Like on your phone.
I love boobies, big boobies. Jugs, just for. Listen, ooh, they're on they're on YouTube. We'll just scroll past those. I don't think Twitch will like that.
No.
I don't remember those. There is a part in here that is so fucking fun. Here it is. All right. Sergio Razza, who I think I'm subbed to. Yep. On this account. I don't know who this guy is. Boring Texters. And it's a Facebook video about boring texters. How to flirt with a girl. Important information. Important information. You need to know how to flirt with a girl. Getting over a breakup. What was I YouTubing getting over a breakup?
You wanted. Slashy, you're right.
Oh, God. And then, of course, Justin Bieber Mistletoe. Same guy. I do not remember this guy at all, but apparently I liked him. I subbed to him. I think that's probably it for... Oh, fuck. Tobuscus? Fastest snapper in the world? I didn't realize this was a fake video. I only remember this as the fastest snapper in the world, but I didn't realize that was Tobuscus. A little bit of workout videos.
Ew. Cyst.
This video, I used to think it was the pinnacle of fucking comedy.
What is it? Is it funny?
No.
Well?
It's not.
Food. You know, I just couldn't stop thinking about it.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I went to the fridge and I opened up the meat drawer. You know what the meat drawer is, right?
Yeah. What was in there?
Well, I'll tell you what was in there. You know that bacon that's like maple? It's got maple flavor.
The maple kind, yeah.
Yeah. So
250
yeah.
million.
I took that out. And I thought,
yeah,
I know who would like that. Me. So I ate it.
Oh, no.
Yeah, I remember that.
Me.
It's cute.
I used to love that video. Anything else here? Anything else here? A little bit of Jenna Marbles.
Anyone watch fucking Nate and Destry videos? I vividly remember the one where Destry does a tutorial on how to do his hair. But I haven't seen them in a long time, so I don't know how they held up.
Okay. And this is going to be the last. This is going to be the last section of Josh lore. This was 2014, I think. 2014? No, I would have been in college. I think this is 2012. I think all of this timeline was 2010 to 2012. I really got into acapella. I don't know who Destry is.
It's a guy from a YouTube channel I used to watch when I was like 13 because
I think it's a pretty good bet of anybody that was a guy from a YouTube channel like 2013 is a bad guy. Yeah. This
I don't wanna look it up.
This comes into my last phase of acapella. I loved mashups, of course. Call Me Maybe in a Heartbeat, obviously. But I really started getting into. Oh, it only had one? Because now this is all the stuff we've been watching. I used to love M. Bennett. Thank you for asking. I, of course, had a Glee phase. I loved Glee. I watched seasons 1, 2, and 3 of Glee live. And boy, did I fucking love that show. Who is my favorite on Glee? Probably the dude who's dead. The main character guy. I can't remember his name. But probably that guy. That dude was chill. Yeah, Corey. Yeah. Probably that guy. I thought he was pretty chill.
Did he die in real life?
Yes. Yes, yes,
oh,
yes.
No.
Yeah, he died a couple of years ago. But I liked that show. It's cringe.
I don't like
it. It's cringe as hell.
I can't stand it. I don't know why, but my brain just will not let me watch musicals. Like, it hurts. Even though I loved choir and I was in choir from like kindergarten until my senior year of high school, I can't fucking watch musicals. It hurts me. Also, for anyone interested, I found out what Destry did.
Uh-oh. Is it a content warning type thing?
Yeah. So, a little bit of a content warning.
He died 7, 8 years ago, really?
Huh? That's nothing. Crazy.
The Corey guy from...
Basically, like, you know how, like, a lot of pop punk... lead guys have done things. He's done the same shit with people like 12.
Like, okay, that's not ideal.
12, it's fine.
Star Kid musical. Jesus. I don't know what Star Kid is either.
Star Kid? Wasn't that a book series?
Jack Hop or Jack Chop? Is this the right video?
Yeah, Winter Blue. I'm not shocked. I could definitely tell he was one of those gross fucking guys.
Hey.
I vividly remember this video where he was talking about, like, the best features in women to him. And he was talking about, like, the dimples above someone's butt or something. I don't know. But I was like, do I have one of those? I don't know. It was just stupid. And I'm upset that I watched his videos, but glad I was never in contact with him.
Okay. Do you know this video, Aurora?
Huh?
Jack Chop?
What? If it's fucking like Slap Chop, yes.
What am I about to watch? There's a lot of blood. I don't know if I can watch this on Twitch. Is it fake blood?
Yeah.
I know it's fake blood, but like, is it fake blood in the thing? I don't know if I'm supposed to watch this on Twitch.
That's gross, Winter.
That's a lot of blood.
You're not lying.
Yeah, I don't think I'm supposed to watch this on Twitch.
I'll watch it later.
I'll watch it later. Yeah, that looks like bad times for me. I'm not trying to get banned. I know it's fake, but I don't think Twitch likes it.
It'll see the color, it'll see the shape, and it'll be like...
Well, it'd have to be manually reviewed, but I don't think we should do that. Whitest kids you know... Whitest kids you know. Listen, if it was my Twitch account, I'd do it, but it's not my Twitch account. It's
the judges.
The judges. Wise Kid You Know, loved Wise Kid You Know. We don't need to watch...
Rest in peace, Trevor Moore.
Yeah, R.I.P. Trevor Moore. I don't think we need to watch The Grapist. We can agree...
We already know about it.
I'm sorry, big boob buttersticks. Switch to Hot Girl. Just go live on Hot Girl 99. Yes. The thing... YouTube is crazy, and I know we're all of our brains are just broken, but it's crazy how long videos used to be.
Yeah.
Like, this video does not need to be 5 minutes long. Sexiest white beans. For
why are they sexy? There's a couple people... at my work who are still teenagers, and they use sexy as a verb.
What?
No, as a descriptive word.
For like what?
Everything. It's so weird to me. I don't understand, but that's probably because I'm old.
Like, they'll just see clothes on the rack and
yeah,
be like,
they're
that's
like,
sexy.
That's really sexy. I'm like, and they, I don't know. No, beans aren't sexy. I don't like beans. The texture's wrong. It hurts me.
Aurora doesn't like beans. You know what we might be able to do, actually? We'll put this on while it goes. I'm going to look up. I have a... this will be the last thing we do, and then we'll probably end stream. I have a playlist. I have a playlist on my YouTube that is called, Funniest Video Ever or something like that. Or Funniest, like, Funny or Comedy or something like that. And we can show some of my favorite YouTube videos, and then we'll probably call it. I never watched Llamas with Hats. Oh, I have videos on my main YouTube as well.
Just two.
Yeah, it's only two. But one of them's got Christian in it, so like that's slightly more...
You still hear Pissy Chrissy?
Relevant. Christian knows about this video. All right. This is going to be really bad audio because I took this at a... I took this at a music festival at Mad Decent Block Party in Cicero. And Jack Yu was playing, was headlining. I don't know who was playing at this time. But this is a video of young Christian. This is a music festival in 1956.
It's awful.
That's it. But look at little baby boy Christian. I turned the audio way down because you guys don't need to hear it. But look at little baby boy Christian.
Young man. A young friend, as it was.
Look at that cut. Look at that. It's clean. It's got two comments on it.
One's from Josh and one's from...
This is very accurate, Josh, 1 month ago. Thanks. Yeah, of course, now Christian has beard, mustache.
Long hair.
Jacked now. Okay. And then the other one. It looks like half of his lunch tray would be ranch.
Oh, she's seen it, Slushy, many times.
This is my college roommates. Jake is sitting in the chair. This is not me. It looks like me in the purple shirt, but it's not me. Jake in the purple chair, friend of the pod, has been on the show twice on Halloween episodes.
Dude, what the fuck? Get off, dude.
That's it. We used to fuck with Jake so hard. All right, let me look up oops, my what's it called?
Hello, I'm Joanna Rohrbeck of Prancercise LLC, and I'm here today to show you the four modes of Prancercise. I've got my ankle weights in place, and my music's ready. So let's stop talking and do some walking.
The guitars. I don't remember the guitar. Their pants are too white. Luis called Christian a fat bitch. That was back, people, if you listen to H3H3 or watch H3H3, he used to call himself a thick bitch and would pull his pants up and show his ass crack, or just, like, show his ass. Bye, Griff. Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you for stopping by. We're ending soon. But we used to call each other thick bitches. It was when Christian and Luis and I were living together. And Luis got home from work and was sleeping, and Christian and I were just in the living room laying on different couches. And Luis comes out, lays on top of Christian, face to face like this, looks him dead in the fucking soul, and just goes, "You're a fat bitch." And Christian wanted to cry so fucking bad.
Aww.
But yeah. All right, while this is playing, I'm going to get this last playlist here. Yeah, the toe's there. Fat bitch merch? What?
So, is this woman serious?
There's no way this is serious.
But she's, like, actually that old.
All right.
That's what her face
it's
looks
really
like.
Really hot.
I just can't buy that this is sincere. Like, she would have to be similar to a horse's gait and as ideally induced by elation. Copyright 1989.
Oh.
And she has a book?
Well,
I can't tell if it's, I don't know. I don't think it's
this
real.
This video is definitely not from 1989.
She only has, it's surprising that she only has 15,000 subs. She's posting 3 years ago.
Let's see. Click on one.
Celebrate July 4th? Why, of course. I don't just move like a horse. I'm a health nut and a patriot that likes
truck. Okay. I need to take notes. She just rhymed nut with patriot. That's pretty good.
I also feel like Lady Liberty. I live in the land of the free and can be who I want to be. May I also say hooray! My birthday is only a few days away. So, for all you creeps that don't want to share in my bliss, I've got a suggestion for you. You can just kiss my grits.
She's real.
Yep, she's real. She's not dead because she's still tweeting. So whoever said that she stopped posting because she's dead, she is, in fact, still alive and alive. She's still tweeting.
Is she an all caps tweeter like Robert Smith?
A goofy Xmas tune?
All right.
This is what happens
if
you don't put down
horse pills. I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. Only a hippopotamus will do. I don't want a dog or tinker tinker dog. Only a hippopotamus to play with and enjoy. I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. I don't think Santa Claus will mind you. He won't have to use our dirty chimney flue.
Just pretty good audio quality.
It was made recently, John.
But I mean, like, for her being outside, that's pretty good.
Through the front door, it's the easiest to do. How I leave myself
on
Christmas morning, creeping down the stairs. Oh, what joy and what surprise.
We ain't got to watch all of these. But I have this list. I don't know when I made it. Last updated on 2018. I think these are some of the funniest videos ever made. I don't know why this is on here. I think there's one moment in this that's really funny. This show was on...
It's true, Slush.
What's up?
Slushy loves her because even though people made fun of her, she kept being herself. That's very true.
That's true. I mean, yeah, good for her.
I feel bad now.
You shouldn't feel bad. College humor, very funny. This is what I got my musical inspiration from. I aspire to be this man.
This guy makes me laugh. His name is Zach Braff. This guy makes me laugh. His name is Zach Braff. This guy makes me laugh. His name is Zach Braff. This guy makes me laugh. His name is Zach Braff. You wanna know who my favorite actor is? He's the hardest working dude in the acting biz. No, it's not Bradley Cooper or Ed Helms, that's whack. It's not Galifianakis, it's a different Zach. I thought he was the best person on the show Scrubs. Then I found out that he came up with the show. Forget about The Office and Parks and Recreation. When I see those shows, I change the TV station to look for my favorite show with my favorite guy. It's on so many channels that I don't even have to try. WGN, Comedy Central, and ABC. These are the channels where I watch my favorite repeats. Thanks for putting Scrubs in syndication so we can enjoy this classic all over the nation. The show has so many great characters and storylines. Internal monologues and daydreams are so divine. I love the romance story of Elliot and JD, but sometimes I wish it wasn't her, it was me. Every day I check his IMDb once more to see if he has any future projects in store. I watched Garden State and I didn't really get it, but it's still my favorite movie because it has Zach Braff in it. Zach, I see you trying to blend in with the wall, but you can't hide from me, Zach. I'm the biggest fan of them all. This guy makes me laugh. His name is Zach.
The cut in and out of the rap is so fucking bad, and I love it so much.
Zach Braff. This guy makes me laugh. His name is Zach Braff. This guy makes me laugh. His name is Zach Braff. This guy makes me laugh. His name is Zach Braff.
The nominees for Best Actor are Zach Braff for Scrubs, Zach Braff for Garden State, Zach Braff for Chicken Little, and Zach Braff for The Last Kiss. And the winner is... Zach Braff!
He's the reason why everyone should have a TV. If you don't have cable, better get the DVD. Scrubs was gonna stop at the end of season 6, but they made another season, so I guess we got a freebie.
Freebie. I'm no Superman.
This guy makes me laugh. His name is Zach Braff. This guy makes me laugh. His name is Zach Braff. This guy makes me...
So yeah, that's my comedy styling. Of course, Mom Spaghetti. I think this is the single... No, that wasn't me. Believe it or not. This is, I think, the single best piece of sketch comedy ever made. Love the acting. He's so upset with himself. Damn it.
That was pretty good.
Yeah.
Now watch Gravy Robbers.
These are some edgier videos, but they're very funny. Gravy Robbers?
Yeah. Gravy Robbers. Come on, it's easy.
Hello, robbers. My name is Terry Green. And not too long ago, I was in the same position as you are now, about to become a proud gravy robber. Those were the good old days. As you know, your mission is to steal as much of our award-winning gravy from as many customers as you can. The key to becoming a good gravy robber is to keep yourself in peak physical condition, because you're going to be required to stay in stealth position for hours, crouching, lingering, hovering. You're going to need to creep up on the other customers. So when you go and you snatch that gravy up from the customer's table, you'll be prepared.
Is this from Tim and Eric?
Yeah, obviously. He's done.
Wonderful. Wonderful, Aurora. Thank you very much. It's definitely strange. Guys, check out this channel. They make very good content about Neopets that I've been watching, and I'm very excited to watch more about like My Little Pony and stuff. We're going to end right now. Thank you. I think it was fun. Thank you for being cringe with me or watching me be cringe.
It was fun.
Do you enjoy it?
Mm-hmm.
Sorry that there were so many lewd videos in my YouTube watch history in 2011. But hey.
Being a teen.
It's not like sexual content is free online. You have to look at it. You have to
look at it on YouTube.
You gotta. It'd be weird if you didn't. But yeah, we're going to end it, guys. Thanks for stopping by.
Thank you.
I appreciate each and every one of you.
You're welcome.
And I promise I will rap for all of you the Pokemon rap at some point. Maybe I'll actually mix it and like make it sound not like shit. Probably not, though. I'm not making any fucking promises. Was this more cringy than Christian's tweets? No. Christian's tweets were fucking good. That's the difference. But I've got
guns in my head.
And I won't go. Oh, as a final little set off, actually. I meant to bring this up earlier. Aurora and I, of course, Aurora and I, that's true. We do know somebody who made our theme song with good night, Mom. Thank you for staying.
Good night, Angel.
You just got here, Jenny. Well, the VOD should be there to watch back. But Aurora and I, of course, we made a parody that went on Jake and Amir's thing. And then we were trying to write another parody song that didn't make it. But I have a list of other parody songs that we just have the titles for.
Did we actually like do this together?
Yes, you and I did this together. And you'll remember them. So just maybe if you guys are interested, this was all going to be part of a circle jerge that they were parody songs, but all for COVID. And this was a long time ago.
Oh, when it first started happening.
This was when the vaccines first rolled out and we thought that COVID was going to be over. Obviously there's vaccinated instead of vindicated.
Mm-hmm.
I don't remember who vindicated is by.
And Spider-Man. Spider-Man's a music video, I think.
There's Friday I'm in Love by The Cure. We made Pfizer in My Blood.
Sure.
Was the play we had there. I just have Skater Boy Duet.
Sure.
I don't know what that was. Thank You Next by Ariana Grande. But Thank You Vaxxed. That one doesn't work very good. Basket Case by Green Day. I just have written Quarantine because there's a lyric at the beginning that sounds like quarantine.
What did he say? I don't remember.
Let's look up Basket Case lyrics because I don't remember either. Do you have the time? I think it was something about quarantine. To sit in quarantine.
Oh.
I think that's what it was.
Okay.
AC/DC, Back in Black.
I remember.
Do you remember this one? It was. What was it? All I remember is the part where he says, "It's like Back in Black, and we're back in black." It was rest in peace to Grandpa Jack.
Yeah.
And it was a song about somebody dying because they didn't get the vaccine.
Yeah. I think it was about, like, anti-vaxxers.
It was about anti-vaxxers, yeah. Yeah, it was specifically about anti-vaxxers. Call Me Maybe. And that we have lyrics written out for this one. So it's the opening verse of Call Me Maybe. We put the mask on our face, quarantine shelter in place. Now Bill and Melinda Gates put chips into our arms.
Also anti-vax.
That's pretty good.
Song about people who don't want to get them.
And that's it. So as you can see, we're very professional songwriters. Thanks for hanging out, guys. I promise I'll rap for all of you. M, I don't know if I'm going to fully produce it, but I'll definitely rap. Maybe Aurora will sing backup. I said maybe. But for now, goodbye, everybody. I wish we had, like, a backup or, like, an end song. But go check out Kip. I'm going to raid Kip. Tell them what's up. Have a good time. Bye.